Hello everyone, welcome to this online course on American literature. At the outset, I would like to introduce myself. I am Dr. T. Malathi Gabriel, Assistant Professor, Head Department of English and IQAC Coordinator, Vivekan Government College, Chittoor. I am also a researcher, reviewer, soft skills trainer and recipient of Gold Medal for securing university first rank in MA English Literature. As this is an introductory class, the first topic is entitled as The Beginning, American History and Literature. The objective of this presentation is to make you all to get acquainted with the history and literature of America. Why? Because as students of literature, one have to trace back to its history in order to have a broader perspective of the concept. And as far as the knowledge about American literature is concerned, the history really helps a lot to comprehend it very easily. To deal with this topic is really an exciting, interesting, and amazing experience because this is a nation which was not known to the entire world until 15th century. But when we observe the saga of its expeditions, its settlements, its two categories, the first one is about Native American period. It deals with who are the real natives of America, how they got there, what is their period, and what is their culture, tradition, and occupation. The next topic is about discovery of America. It is very interesting to deal with. Who are the people who started expedition to America? What is the aim behind in its discovery? And how the nation got its title or focused in this part? And the third one is about New England colonies. How the newly discovered nation has established itself with colonies, with the colonies of England. And it also deals with what are the nations that began to dominate in this newly discovered land. And also the reasons behind in establishing these colonies. And finally, the distinctive features of American literature are dealt in a broader way. Let me start with a quote by John Winthrop, which he delivered as a sermon in the ship, the name of that ship is Arabella, in April 1630, and this sermon is entitled as A Model of Christian Charity. Actually, John Winthrop, along with a team of sailors, he went to America. When he was about to reach the American continent, he gave this emphatic speech which made them to arouse into action, and he dreamt of a mighty nation which he was about to reach. And he strongly advocates, the Lord will dwell among us, his own people, the God of Israel is among us, for we must consider that we shall be as a city upon a hill. The eyes of all people are upon us, and to shut this discourse with the exhortation of Moses, that the Lord our God may bless us in this land, whither we go to possess it. Yes, in the Old Testament, the God strongly proclaimed to Moses, his prophet, they are going to inherit the land, the fertile land with milk and honey. In the same manner, the people of England, people like John Winthrop, they believed that they are going to possess it. Native American period, exactly. This period belongs to pre-1600, and during this period, the real natives of America were in numerous indigenous families of tribal people. Actually, these people came to this continent via land bridge that connected from Siberia to Alaska. It was the opinion of the historians. The people began to settle there. They developed their own distinctive culture. No written written literature, only oral traditions of songs and stories existed. And in course of time, that land bridge got disappeared, and hence the connection between the American nation and to the rest of the world was not known. Discovery of America. See, when we read the discovery of America, really we feel thrilled and engrossing, because actually the real expedition to American nation has started from 1000 AD, in which Viking Erikson has, along with his troop, went to this nation. But his expedition was not known to the world. It went unrecognized. After 500 years, in 1492, Christopher Columbus, the Italian explorer, he visited this land. Actually, he landed on the Caribbean islands, which was between North America and South America. But he thought that by observing the people of Native America, observing the people, the natives of America, he thought them as Indians. The main aim to discover this nation by Christopher Columbus was to discover sea route from Europe to Asia. At that time, Asia, particularly India, is a hot cake. So people from Europe aspired to have trade and commerce with India. And with this aim, he started his expedition. And after he discovered America, that nation came to be known to the entire world as New England, the Promised Land, and the Heaven on Earth. But there comes the other hero. We all talk about the Christopher Columbus, who discovered America for the first time in 1492, other than the Vikings. But Amerigo Vespucci, he is a mathematician, navigator, map maker, a skilled sailor, and a multifaceted personality. He also visited America after Christopher Columbus, but his experience was entirely different from the experience of Christopher Columbus. Why? Because as a navigator, as a map maker, he began to study about the continent with the knowledge he possessed. And he came out with a new revolutionary concept that Christopher Columbus not landed in India. It was not India. Rather, it is a separate continent. And he has given a picture to it. And he identified it as a separate continent. Later on, Martin Waldisi Muller, the German cartographer, designed a world map in which he gave the name America to this continent, a Latinized version of Amerigo, as an honor to the findings of Amerigo Vespucci. New England colonies. Here, I would like to make a mention of why this land attracted so many people from Europe and Asia, especially because the people other than Asia, the Europeans, they went to England as migrants. Why? Because this continent has immense natural and mineral wealth. It attracted explorers and conquering armies, and hence they began to migrate to this land. And most of the migrants were middle class shopkeepers, artisans, craftsmen, weavers, and so on. And in order to extend their empire, the mighty people, the so-called countries in Europe, they went there. Spain and Portugal settled in Central and South America, whereas England and France looked North America and Caribbean islands. And they established colonies there. Mainly, 13 colonies were established from 1623 to 1733, and majority of the people are Britishers, and next to Britishers were German, Dutch, and Swedish settlers. The Revolutionary War. They settled there for some years And for the first time, as mostly the people are from the Britain, and the British resigned their governance, their imperialism was started there at America. And hence, the natives, they become natives there, and they don't want to be called hereafter as native American Indians. They left the word India, and they wished or desired to have to be called as Native Americans. And the Britishers levied heavy taxes upon them. It was not liked by them. And hence, the 13 colonies, for the first time united in a Congress, they boycotted trade with England and fought a six-year revolutionary war. It was also known as American War of Independence. On 4th July 1776, 13 colonies signed the Declaration of Independence, which was drafted by Thomas Jefferson and proclaimed themselves the United States of America. Next comes the topic, American literature. The American literature can be broadly classified into four categories based on its time period and also about the system it has adopted. From 1607 to 1765, it is colonial literature. Then comes the revolutionary period from 1765 to 1800, and romanticism from 1800 to 1865, realism from 1865 to 1918, and modernism from 1918 to 1945, and finally the contemporary literature from 1945. Colonial literature, during this period, the English adventures were reflected in their writings, the life of colonists in the New World, their experiences, their style, everything is presented, is portrayed. And the literature is in the form of pamphlets, diaries, journals, letters, sermons, and travel books. Captain John Smith, for the first time, he began to make friendship with the Native Americans, the indigenous tribes, and he is the first person who had cordial relationships with them, and he settled there. He began to establish a fine colony for the Britishers. And he has written his experiences in the form of a book, and it is known as, and hence he is considered as the first American writer. In his writing, settlers were portrayed as God's chosen people elected to civilize. During this colonial literature, Puritan literature also came into the limelight and the forefront. Why? Because the main reason for the people, for the Europeans to come and settle in America was due to three reasons: economic reasons, political reasons, and also religious reasons. Major works during this period is John Mead's A Description of New England, William Bradford's A Plymouth Plantation, Annie Bradstreet's The Tenth Muse, Cotton Mather's The Wonders of the Invisible World, and Thomas Paine's Common Sense. In all these writings, the life, the English adventures of the colonial picture was depicted in a beautiful way. And also the Puritanism. Then comes the literature of revolution. As the title itself suggests that it is about revolution, about the cultural confrontations, the constraints, the struggles faced or encountered by the people of the Native Americans with the Britishers. And these are all reflected in Samuel Adams, Benjamin Franklin, and Thomas Paine's writings. During the post-war period, Thomas Jefferson's United States Declaration of Independence is considered a masterpiece and it has become a hashtag for everyone. I would like to read some of the lines from his writing. All men are created equal, that they are endowed by their creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Romanticism, traces back to 1800 to 1865. It emphasized emotion over reason. Individualism and freedom of expression was given utmost priority, and they strongly opined that natural world is inherently good. And during this romantic period, Edgar Allan Poe's writings were reflected the romantic appeal. This period gave rise to transcendentalism. Here I'd like to mention about Ralph Waldo Emerson, Margaret Fuller, and Henry David Thoreau. During this period, Washington Irving's Rip Van Winkle, James Fenimore Cooper's Leather Stocking Tales are the major works. Realism. And during this period, realistic form of narrative presentations are there in the writings. Picture of ordinary emotions and manners of American existence were given prominence. For example, Mark Twain's Power and Glory and Stephen Crane's works also reflects the realistic portrayal of themes and characters. Soon after, realism gave rise to naturalism, and it was influenced by Charles Darwin's theory of evolution. Naturalism shaped a vision of human struggle and defeat of enduring power and value. The best example for naturalism is Emile Zola and Stephen Crane and Frank Norris' writings, and this period is from 1865 to 1918. Modernism, this period is from 1918 to 1945. And this period has witnessed world wars, and hence Henry Adams, professor of medieval history at Harvard University, has rightly defined the modernism of American period as multiplicity, diversity, complexity, anarchy, and chaos. All these things were reflected in the writings of William Carroll, Henry James, Fitzgerald, William Faulkner, Eugene, Tennessee Williams, and so on. Definitely, the American modernism redefined the relationship between the artist and his work, aesthetic form, and literary conventions. Contemporary literature, and we are a part of it, and from 1945 till this period has been going on. During this period, African-American literature, diasporic writings, the Beat Generation writings, Jewish-American literature, American postmodernism and science fiction, and so on, were all interdisciplinary themes, were all presented, portrayed in the contemporary period. This is the bibliography. Thank you.